Welcome, y'all, to another Skip Barber race here at Imola. Our races this week will be the last time we see Imola for a while, since this will be the third season we've run Imola in the Skip Barber series, and that's how they do their rotation. And in practice today, I was able to get close to my previous fastest lap. I think if I had kept going, I would have been able to get better than my fastest lap. And as always, no big surprise, it was the hairpin and that one turn that's kind of a diving right-hand sweeper to the left-hand one before the straight line, and then the chicane. I think it's Aqui something, if I remember from last season. Anyways, here we go. Forgot.
Green, green, green.
And for some reason today, for qual and whatnot, I've been very, very nervous.
Right side. You're in the middle. Three wide. Left side. Two wide. Clear.
And I know better than that. I should have been protecting the inside, because if you don't, somebody gets overeager and is like, oh, hey, look, a gap. I can fit in there. Thought I was sliding, I wasn't. And then failed the recovery. We'll have to see if we can make up that time somehow. This is the turn I was thinking of. But then again, I'll get one, and then it's the chicane that'll get me next. It's one of those three, but typically the first two, and the chicane doesn't help. What's fun is I've gained like 3/10 of a second in the first sector. Oh. Unfortunate for Brian. Hello.
Clear on the right.
Not sure if they got a cutting penalty or they were just trying to lift to let us go by or what. That was very sudden and unexpected. Yeah, track temps are a bit cooler than default weather, even though it is actually the afternoon for this week, and not late afternoon or morning. How did he drop back to 4 seconds behind us? I mean, even if he didn't serve a cutting, well, I overbroke quite a bit there. Ooh, that's unfortunate. So my two biggest failures on the chicane was I was at first braking too early. I pinched that. And then I was braking too much, like trying to actually use the, I think I was just probably not feeling very comfortable with it, so I was over braking to the speed. When just letting the car ride once you're at the right speed does wonders. Oh, yeah, I really missed my turn in there. I think we're catching somebody in front of us. I say that, but Brian is car number two, so he's probably quite a bit faster than we are. Unless he has damage of some kind. And for him to fall back that much, it probably does. Or he just had some problem. Not sure exactly what I'm doing so wrong there. I mean, I'm over braking, but I don't know why exactly. I think it's some of it may just be the difference in weather between default and this. So I'm getting caught out a lot more than I should be. Because I don't need to brake as much. Keep missing that apex. Like, even in practice, I've been kind of struggling with that all of a sudden, which is weird. And I think it's just me trying to turn in a bit later.
2:05.956.
Yeah, we're going to need to find at least a second if we want to catch anyone. And making mental mistakes like that is not going to do it. And I'm being very careful to not overdo that turn now. With what happened last season. Which I've generally tried to be careful about it, but I'm being extra careful now. I think I got a little too much curb there. Because the fraction bit of time I'm going to gain is nowhere near enough to make up for the amount of time I'm going to lose when I mess it up. And since I don't have the consistency to be able to push that each and every time, I'm probably going to end up on average losing more than I would gain per race. The two in front of us are fighting it out, and we're not really losing us. But we're not really gaining on them very well either. We're gaining on them very much. I guess either works. Just very well didn't sound right. And at this weather, I would expect to be down in the fours somewhere. since it's close to 20 degrees cooler, and in iRacing that means a lot more grip. So one issue though is I think today I tried something a little bit different since I actually had some more time. Since it's currently the day after Christmas, otherwise known as Boxing Day to other parts of the world. But I wanted to try, like, doing practice and then quitting early. And not doing what I normally do, which is practice all the way up until the race. Yeah, I was over pushing it on the straight before that turn, which is why I missed it that time. Because I got greedy on a turn before that, trying to get on the gas early. So that was one of those compounding, doubling down errors. So I wanted to try to give myself a bit more of a break between actual finishing practice and the race. To see if that would help. And I think it did the exact opposite. Because now I've had more time to think about it, and I hate pre-game. Like, honestly, I do my best when I have zero time to think and psych myself out before something. Yeah, we are making no headway on the folks in front of us. Losing ground, much ground to the people behind us. I feel like Lee will catch us eventually if we don't pick it up a bit, though. I think the line was better on that turn, I just didn't get on the gas early enough. I'm still losing a bunch of time somewhere. It's funny, I can get a lap that gains like 0.35 seconds there on that first turn or first set of chicanes. And it still doesn't get anywhere near my optimal. So I have no idea what I did during my optimal run to get to go as quick as I did. I think the folks in front of us's battle ended. It'd be interesting to see what happens to their pace. Pretty sure Brian there, car number two, is gonna just take off. the other guy. I mean, if he was really that much slower, then they wouldn't have been battling for so long, but we'll see. There we go. Those are the times we need to start seeing. So funny to me though, because I'm barely on the brakes, or at least what I think. And I still end up going way too slow. So the guy in front of us is no longer getting pulled along by the number two car. I was like, that's a little bit optimistic. Let's back out of that. And I think one of my biggest problems through that series of turns was either going too fast and having a really weird line while doing too fast, so I was hitting things, which is disrupting the car and making it unhappy. And an unhappy Skippy is not a fast Skippy. Much slower, but I think he still pulled away on us. Y'all will be able to tell. I can't. Because I forgot to look at, find a common place to take a delta measurement. I think our biggest problem is normally I get some laps in on Sunday, and I was not able to do that this week. I didn't think it'd be that big of a deal though, since this will be our third season here and we seem to have a decent pace here usually. We're our own biggest enemy here, more than anybody else. Still have three laps. I mean, if he makes a small mistake, we'll be all over him.
2:05.448.
We definitely have gained on him since last time around. Yeah, I was pretty sure that we weren't going to make that next turn without that little bit of a lift. Now I'm just being silly. And pushing too hard. Which goes back to our earlier conversation about our own worst enemy. Oh, I wonder what happened to David there. So I had to go back to the pits. Last I looked, it was him and Lee were neck and neck. Oop.
They say you cut the course. You'll have to slow down and give up the time gained.
Come on. We want to get it before the chicane, because after the chicane, and it's just, or if you go through the chicane with that, you're more than likely going to get more, no matter how slowly you do it, it seems. And unfortunately, that just removed all the pressure from the guy in front of us.
You've got two laps to go.
But it was a silly mistake that we shouldn't have made. Well, that's kind of how that goes. As you can see, that 1 second slowdown usually is a lot more than 1 second worth of a penalty. I'd really like to know how iSpeed calculates those, because they don't seem to quite work like you would think they do, or should. I mean, I know I'm kind of complaining about it, and the easiest way to deal with it is to just not get them. I think he made a mistake or two. Fortunately, with giving him all that time back, is very unfortunate, because we'd be all over him right now had we not had to do that. I say that's kind of an example of what I mean by when I was kind of overdoing it on breaking through that chicane, even though the speed we had when we came out of it seemed to be fine. Yeah, we've definitely gained a lot of time on him for some reason. He may just be taking it easy because he feels like we're never going to catch him.
2:05.024.
Which in these last two laps, if he's... is probably true.
Well, come on, Joe. You're on the outside. Stay on the outside, man. I couldn't go anywhere on the inside then.
Is that a generic Joe, or is there actually a Joe in this race I didn't see? Or he may have meant Joel. I mention it more because I definitely did not remember seeing a Joe. Now we'd have a total... we'd really have had a chance of catching him had we not made that one cutting mistake. Ah, well, that's just how it goes. Just don't make the mistake next time. That'll be the goal. Well, that's kind of the goal every time.
You got about 5 laps of fuel.
Oh no, what will we do? And we've been so far away from everyone that we haven't even needed to use one of our tear-offs yet.
Guys. It was a lot of fun. Yeah, we can race with no contacts all the way, and then we race with Joe, we got contacts there.
It could have been worse. I'll take it as a first race. So like most times you're here at this track, it's off tracks for everyone. If we could have kept doing those fours, we would have been very competitive for the mid-pack. But we'll just have to work more on that in practice, is getting a little more consistency going there. Like before, we made a few mistakes early on lap one, turn one specifically. We really need to work more on defending the inside of that turn. Not to mention our turn in there when we were three wide was atrocious. I mean, I think if there was anybody else there with us coming in behind us, I would have taken them out. It was that bad. So yeah, that about sums up that race. With that, if you like, leave a like. If you didn't, leave a dislike. If you have any questions, suggestions, feedback, or advice, drop it in the box below. Good luck in your races, and y'all take it easy.